Hi everyone, so happy you took the time again to come over and watch a new video from Diane and me. For everyone who is new here, my name is Jannie and I'm doing this channel together with my daughter-in-law Diane. And for everyone who is here already for a long time, thank you so much for every time stopping by and giving such a sweet comment. Thank you for that. And today it is a very happy day, at least I hope it will be, because I am going to make my first gnome. And today this is a challenge day for the beautiful Donna from Creative by Nature. She is the queen of making little gnomes and little figurines because she always creates such a beautiful little world. I always love to see that, especially around the Christmas time. I always get a lot of inspiration from her, so I will link her channel down below, so go check it out, you won't be sorry. And of course I will put a link down below with the playlist with all the beautiful creators who are joining Donna in this great challenge, so you find there a lot of inspirations of gnomes, so go check it out. And for me, this will be my first time doing a gnome, so I will make two of them. So I hope that it will turn out right, but of course I never know because it is the first time. And I take you along in the whole DIY, so I hope you enjoy watching. And of course, what I always say, if you like this video, if you like this content, I hope you will consider subscribing to Diane and my channel. So enough talking, let's jump into our DIY. So here you will see what I will use for my little gnome. And of course, I have here a little faux, a table cloth. If you know, if that's what you call it, mat is what it calls here. And it was only €1.70. And of course, I will make a beard out of this. And of course, I have some socks I will use, some creamy one and some black one. Of course, some bells and some beads, some rice. Here in the Netherlands we call it rijst, you see here, and some ribbon and some rope. I already said some mud pots. I don't know if I use everything, but most of the time I just gather everything around me so I can film it behind each other. So, and for this one I am also trying to do the most of the time I will show you everything because it is for me also the first time I'm making a Christmas gnome. So I hope you are coming along with me so we can learn together. So I really have no idea how this one also will turn out, but we are going to try to do our best and to make a Christmas gnome out of it. So we will see. So what we first are going to do, but what I just saw, what is not the greatest, that's already the first mistake. When you have some socks, they can't have lettering under it, because or else you will see it in your gnome. So I cut this one off. Of course, I'm using the upper piece, so I hope this will turn out right because you have now a smaller piece. But first I'm going to glue this together. I hope this will work the way I have it in my head, but I don't know if this will work or not because you are working with some rice. So, and of course I will use an elastic band, difficult word. So I hope this will work a little bit. So if you use it, just use socks. They don't have a lettering under it, because or else you will see it in your gnome. And even when I'm turning them inside out, you still have the letters. And I think I don't get them so easily away when I'm correct. Maybe. At least I don't think so, that the lettering will disappear very easy. At least I have to see if I'm, you see, they don't disappear that easy. So I'm going to try to use this piece, but of course I can use it, I have to use a little piece of band also here, so that was not the way I planned it. So I will have to see if this will work or not. But if I turn this around right now, now you see already. And now I have also on the top of that, I will have to use an elastic band. Sorry for that, guys. So sorry. I used some rice. We are going to, I just glue it together, and you see I glue everything great together. Again, already so much chaos, so now I'm going to try and to get some rice in here. This one close to the table. So just a couple ice. Now we are going to do some. I think I will do, maybe I should have done here also a piece of wire instead of an elastic band, because the elastic band sometimes don't stay that great, so I think I will glue this one also. So I do just do a piece of rope. I hope you can see what I do. So just cutting it off. So this is a little bit of the piece I will have under. I really have a feeling that maybe I could have done a little bit more inside of, because I don't want a big gnome, but I don't know if he's now a little bit too little. So that's also a try you have to do. I think I could have done a little bit more, so I will do a little bit more rice in it. Of course, you have to just have to try and go with it, and just what you personally prefer, of course. I think I need a little bit more. Maybe if you use some, that will be working a little bit better. That, so again, I'm just doing my piece of rope around it and just do a knot on it. At least I hope it's that you call it that you call it a knot. Maybe you don't. Here in the Netherlands we call it knopen. So een knoop heb ik erop gedaan. This will be already a very strange, unique gnome. So now I'm going to take a piece of my black. And of course, I will do a second one also. So I have two gnomes, because I want to have two gnomes. So I'm going to do the second one out of the camera. So you see, I have now two under pieces for my gnome. I give them the creamy color, but you can do, of course, any color you like, just what is your personal privilege. And of course, I just wanted to show you how easy I just cut the up top of the socks off. So you can also use any color socks you want. And now I'm taking the black ones, and I am going to cut the, also again, the top from above I will cut off, but I do a little bit further, and this one also, because I have two of them, a little bit further like here. And I have a little bit more room. What I will do, because they are going to be the top, because you do this way, and you are making here his head from with a little bell on it. So of course he gets to get better, he gets to get better on it. But this way a little bit I do. What I do first is go to do this one together. I'm doing it inside out. And I'm just getting the pieces together, so make a little, so that you have a little top also. And I'm also doing this one with rope, because if you do, you can also do an elastic band, because, but I'm always afraid when they dry out, everything will fall apart. And if you want to have used of them a little bit longer than a year, then you have to use a little rope, maybe. Then they stay better. So I do one in here. I will cut this one off and I'll fit this piece also to give it a little bit shorter and maybe a little bit on the top. So it will, the top will be a little bit less height. So turning it upside down again. And of course I'm going to do a little piece. Now you get a little knob around here. Most of some people just use this and just do the tops, you see. You just can use it as a top, but I'm doing, at least I'm going to try to give it over here and just make a little knob inside, of course. So just pull it, the little knob on, and just work your way so you have a little knob around here. So take a little piece of ribbon, just do it around it and just make also a knob over here. I should have got a little bit longer piece that is a little bit more easy to work with. But one way or the other way, every time my camera is running and I have to do, everything goes wrong, or I have things too short, things too high, and just call it. So just when you see a little rope outside, and of course what I can do is just glue a little bell. I won't try to make not so many noise. You see here I have silver bells and I have gold bells. And I will use the gold one, and I have them in the just the yellow color gold, the lighter color gold, and the glitter gold. And I am going to for this middle piece of gold. So I'm going to try to get one out of there. At least I will try. I will use a scissor, of course. And later on I will do these bells in a little plastic. So what you can do, of course, you can just glue this one on top of it, and you can glue just two on top of here. I will do two, but of course that's your personal privilege. I really have no idea if this will work or not. This is just something I thought maybe it can work, but we don't know. Maybe they don't bell anymore. That can also be a possibility. I have to wait a second. Yes, there he is. Of course, I want to do some hot glue. On my bell. So I do one over here. And one over here. So you have two bells at the end of your knob. But of course, if you like better that you have the way I showed you earlier, then it's also okay. And of course, I will do later on, I will do a little bit of the buffalo check around here. But for it is already, what I'm going to do still is a little piece of wire inside of here, so you also can bend a little bit your head from it. So you see here. And of course, he is not sitting up. This is just even the way you can, it can look. So, but first I'm going to take a piece of wire I'm doing inside of the head, and then I show you how that looked like. So again, I will show you for the second head. The head I will show you again, maybe that you didn't. I just did the end, the top of the sock. I just, like you saw, I just cut off. I just do a little piece together, just do a little piece of rope around it, and again turn it inside out, and just take the little knob what is in, what's inside, just take it together, and again also do a piece of rope. You can also do a piece of ribbon, just what you want. And if you have longer socks, then your head will also be much longer. But for me, because I will have them on my table, I don't want them have so big. So now I'm going to do this one. And I have to squeeze this one. I want the rope together. My hands are not really working today. And now what I'm going to do exactly just two of the lighter bells on it. But you can do the silver, you can do any color you want. So one on top of here. And one on the other side. So you get a little bit two ears. It looks like two little ears. So you see, now I have two of them. And now I'm doing to some wire inside of it. So what I will do is just take a little piece of wire. And of course I have some over here, I see already from last time. So I'm going to see if I can use this one, or he is still. I don't think I can use this one because it takes too long. Just take a piece of wire and just bend it a couple of times together. So I think this is a little bit the height of my head right here. So just do a couple of times and a little bit backwards, and that you get a little bit more. And of course, again, also here, just bend it together, just like a couple of times, just you when you do with ribbon. And I will cut this one. So, and of course I will place it inside of my head, and it doesn't matter, it doesn't have to be, but it's just for the, that you can bend it your own way you want it. So you can just do it inside of it, and I will do the second one also, just a couple of, a little bit measurement how long your head is. This is just a simple idea to do a little piece of wire also inside of your head, so you can bend it a little bit. If you don't want to, it's fine too, you can just leave it and you just don't have to. And of course just bend it together and just turn it a little bit, and also just do it inside of here. Of course, you have to use the other one if you already have one in there. So this one also in here. And this one in here. So now we already finished with that, of course. What we're going to do now. So this was takes a little bit longer for you. It's just a second, but for me it is almost 2 hours later. 2 hours later, because if you have such a fur, it's always a very hard task just to get the beard the way you supposed to be with long hairs. But I just did cut it out and never thought about that then the hairs were cut out too short. So what I'm just found out is that you just do your square. If I am a triangle, at least even in Netherlands we call it a driehoek, so you can look it up, a driehoek, and then you know how it is in English. So I will, what I found out is just do with a scissor just the back of your fur and just try to cut it, only the back fabric. Just do it this way. And with a very sharp scissor this will work great. But it is a task. It is better if you have fur who is fitting already for this. But I just used a little mat. And of course I will just do it this way and almost don't cut it, because or else you lose his long hairs of his beard. And that's where he is famous about, for his beard. And you see, because this is also for me the first time, you see what kind of mistakes there are. If you see just the video which that everything goes right. So you see, just make a square and just pulling it out. And just try to just work your way out of it, and then it will be the greatest beard you have. But you have to do some work for it, because or else you lose his hairs. And I know this takes long for some people, so go forward if it takes too long for you. But now you see also the things that go wrong or go right. So now I'm try to get this one, and sometimes it's a little bit tough to handle, but if you do it this way you just at least get his ears. So you see, now you still have his ears. I have a piece now that I already shaved him. So that doesn't work. So this is a little bit how he has to supposed to look like. So we are going to glue on his beard. Of course you have your whole house under fur, but that doesn't mind. We just glue this one also on top of this. I was cutting this out, but I think my little rope is a little bit too, at least I hope what I do right now is just to show you that my camera is on. And of course, like I always say, it's just a bit chaos again. But so you see, crafting is chaos. And I'm just doing a little knot again, but he was a little bit too wide. And then my rice will fall out. And now I'm going to cut a little bit of the top. But I have to make sure that I don't cut the rope. So this way. Now I'm going to, of course if you look at this way it looks very bad, but when you have it glued on top of your gnome, and of course just remember this is only your first gnome, so at least my first gnome, so I am really looking forward how he will look like. Of course he will glue this one together. And now we're going to do glue this one. I need a new glue. Oh, yep. Now we are trying to get his beard, and of course we will cut it at later. But first we are going to glue it on top of him. And now we take some beads. They are also very cheap. You can use anything you want to use as a bead. And we're going to place this one in the middle of the Now I have to look if I have glued everything together. That's an important thing. If I do the back, if everything is glued. A little piece over here. He already has his beard on, but you see it is just a mess, and it is not that easy. If you show if I can show you the pictures on Pinterest, it is very easy to just cut a triangle, or I think it's a triangle if I am correct, and you see just everything looks so easy. And if you have if you know a little bit how it works, it is easy. But you see, and I'm just gluing a little top of his beard, this piece. I'm just gluing it, I'm just folding it on top of here, only the piece what's in front of it. So now we already have. If you have questions for this chaos, just ask me. And now I'm going to, what I did with the other one is that I pull off the rope. I didn't like it the way it looks like, it looked like. So I just pulled it off because I like it without it better than with. So, but of course it was handy for my little bells. And now I'm going to try to show to you how he. Now I already have to find his nose back. Of course, here is his nose, and he already starting to look like a little gnome. And what I did with the other one is just I just did some glue on top of here and just glue this one together on his head. And what maybe is a little bit better, that you use all the socks who are wider, because this one was new, almost new, and then it's better that you have a little bit wider and some thicker socks. That's always been a little bit better, because these are the thin ones, so just use some little thicker ones for the winter time, then you probably will work still a little bit better than this. So I let this dry right now, and I just do a piece of glue on top of this. And I think Wendy's beard is just, I think he for a first time he looks quite okay. But I let you judge about that. So give me a comment down below what you think about my first gnome and the chaos who is what's here. So, but you see already, I think he looks a lot like a little gnome. And now I'm going to look for if I can do some buffalo check on him, but I will see about that. But you see already, I have two little gnomes. So I show you how I decorated it with him. So here you see This is a day later. Here you see the two little gnomes. And of course, with the beard, I had so much struggle with. And of course, I'm sorry. Every time I say square, but that means here in the Netherlands means a vierkant. But of course, I mean a triangle to make his beard from. So the two gnomes, as you saw already, it is a little bit of a struggle, but it is at the end it turns out great. So it is very easy to do. But this way you also can see an amateur like me also struggles with everything they have when you do a craft for the first time. But I always love to show you that also, that nothing is going right in the video. So you see here I have two little gnomes right now, and what I miss a little bit is a little bit of the Christmassy feeling. So what I think I will do now is just glue a little piece of a red berry. Also doesn't cost anything, you just have one branch, a long branch of it, and just cut some little berry off. You need only one piece, and that's already a little bit enough, because you could do a little piece of greenery, that you say I want a little bit of greenery here. That's not really my thing. So but I think I will do a little berry, one over here, to give him a little bit more of the Christmassy feeling. And what I don't like, is the bead. I like the bead is I like the bead, but not the little holes over here. And I like him, he is for me a little bit too light colored. So what I will do right now is do some little sticky gum inside of the little holes, so it makes a little bit more of a round. And then I will wax him with some furniture wax, and he likes to lie down. You see, this is a little bit more of the these gnomes are a little bit of the chubby gnomes. They're a little bit thicker, so they like to lay down. So I will use this furniture wax just to do his nose a little bit. But first I'm going to use a little bit of the sticky gum just to do the holes with both of them. And I will wax them, and then I'll show you how they look like. So you see, I just wax the little nose in a little bit of the brown color, and I do a second coat on it. And then I hope you don't see really good that there is a little piece of sticky gum on it. And I like it a little bit more this way. And of course, I will glue a little piece of berry on it, at least if the berry stays with me. I'm going to try at least to do a little piece of berry on it. Then you will see it will change already a lot. Just a little glue. And just push it beside the bells. So you see, it gives a little bit of a touch of Christmas. And I will do the second one also. But I have to look that I don't have a big berry, because I don't like that he is so big. And you see, you can just take something out of your branch, and just a little piece of glue. That's always a little bit hard with a glue gun. Just do a little piece. And of course, just stick it in between. I don't hope that I'm with my hairs for you. So you see, this already gives a little bit more of the Christmassy feeling. And it's just remember, it's only a gnome I do for the first time. So it doesn't have to be perfect. It doesn't have to be right away totally elegant or something else. You know what I mean. It's the first time you try, and every time you do it again, you learn on the way. So this I tune in, and now in a moment I show you how I decorate it for a little example. You don't have to do it, of course, it's just an example to show you how it can look like. And I will use this wooden board I just bought with Action. Similar like the Dollar Tree, remember, if you are already here visiting for a couple of times, you know, here in the Netherlands we have just a similar like the Dollar Tree that's called an Action. The only thing I am sad about that they don't have so much of the Dollar Tree, because you have the most beautiful signs, and I saw already you also have to, because we can see this the website from Dollar Tree, but we can't order order it, so it doesn't matter, we make our own. And you see also they had two cute gnomes in the red colors and the gray colors, if I am correct. So I will make a little display to show you just a little bit how you can display your gnomes and how easy it is. You don't need a lot of stuff, so we are going to do that first. So you see what I will do right now, just like I told you, a little vignette. Just a simple bowl, or yeah, so, yeah, I don't really call it, piece of wood. And of course you can use a cutting board if it, and you can paint the cutting board. You can make it totally the way you want it to. But first I'm going to do just a little tree I bought here a couple of weeks ago. And of course I always stick it together with some sticky gum, because I always hate it when you move things around, your whole piece is dropping over. And I speak from experience, that happens a lot. So of course I just want a little piece of the buffalo check back in my decor. So I'm just pinching here a little piece over here. So, and two little gnomes, one over here. And of course one over here, and a little bit sideways that they a little bit are facing each other. Then I will do some pieces of a greenery. Of course I have here, and just make sure that your beard of your little gnome is coming out of everything. You see, just push it a little bit, because I love when he is flourishing a little bit like this, if I am using the correct word, at least I hope I do. Now I will use a piece of greenery, but it's a little bit too much, because or else it will be a little bit too heavy for in to have it in the middle. So I cut a little piece of my greenery. And I'm trying to do a little piece over here, over the buffalo check. And of course a piece over here. And the other side. At least, I hope I do. And this way. So, and now I'm filling it up with some loose ends, because or else it will be too much. But you just do a little bit how you think it feels okay, because there is no right or wrong. Just do fill it up the way you think it's fitting for your decor. Just pull some pieces out of it, and just over here, a couple over here. And you see, with one branch you can make so many pieces. And this one, I think he's a little bit too high, so I will turn him around and just squeeze him a little bit inside of the other piece. So the buffalo check is coming out a little bit, but it doesn't have to be really in front of everything. So a little bit this way. I need some piece over here. Some over here. And I think already from this branch I have enough here on my little board. But you see, I just used a couple of this branch of pieces of this branch, and you see already it gives already a little bit of a Christmassy feeling. What I have here is a little I bought a couple of them. I think I've bought 40 of them. They are go 10 at a pack. These are just little envelopes from Santa Claus North Pole. If you can, I thought maybe you can hang it over here. But of course you don't have to do, you can just move it over here. You can do it this way. You can do it here, that you use two of them. I don't really know if I like it in my display, but first I'm going to do some pieces of greenery still inside of my, this is another piece of greenery. I will do also inside of here. A piece over here, because I always like to let everything come back in the same way. So one over here and the same piece over here. And of course I will cut this one. Maybe I can pull it off. Yes, I can. I do one over here to give it also a little bit of. And now I will use this branch. These are also old branches. I still have the tags on it, but you see they were only $2.99, but I have them already for quite a while. But maybe if I'm lucky, I can push them off. Yes, I can. And you just squeeze a little piece of the bigger over here. Maybe one over here. And just pull one over here at the back. And of course I do in the same one on the other side. I'm sorry, I'm always almost pushing you over. One over here. And I think already that is already more than enough. The only thing what we will miss already, I think you already know what I will what I miss, is are the red touches of berry. I think first I'm going to do a little bit in the middle. And like I said, there is no wrong or right. You just do whatever you think is fitting for your decor. If it is the pink color, you just use the pink color. And if you think it is the red color or the brown color or the gold color, just do whatever you think is right. A little bit over here. I don't want to have it too red. So I will do a little piece of red over here at the back of my little display. But I just squeeze it in so you don't see a little bit of the branches of it. So I think he looks already very Christmassy. So this is a little bit a way how it can look like. Of course you don't have to do it. This is just an example how it can look like. And for what if you like it, what I was thinking about now, you can also pull out some branches and you can glue some couple of the red berries on top of your. I will show you a little bit. This is what comes to mind right now. That's what I always have the trouble with me. Everything is coming to mind and I'm always looking like if it will work or not. So you can glue a couple of them over your tree, and it also gives a unique effect because you buy it this way and you just can make your own twist on it. And of course you can do some, even do some pieces of greenery. You can push it in and you can give it also a little bit of your own touch on it. So there are so many examples you just can do. So but for me, this is how he is looking like. In the moment I show you how he's looking on a piece of fur, so it is a little bit more better to see. So I see you in a moment. So here you see I just did them on a piece of white fur, so you can see a little bit better. You see my little tree made of pieces of wood, and I love just the touches of the red berries I just glued inside, so it makes a little bit of unique piece again for yourself. And of course my two little gnomes, I know it is the first time and most he is not perfect, both of them, but I love how they look like. I had so much fun making it, once at least once I knew how to do it, because I did it in my way. There are lots of ways on Pinterest, so if you want to see a better way, just go into the Pinterest and just look at it. But mine is a little bit easier, and just if you know how to work with it, it is so fast and you can make it very quick. Maybe also with some with your children if you like a little DIY for this season. So I think he looks so nice, at least for the first time. I saw on my camera that it was very dark already, so I just do a little close-up with the lights on so you can see it a little bit better. Sorry if it was a little bit too dark, because there are dark days, but I think he looks so nice. So I hope you did get a little bit inspiration, just maybe so much that you will try one of your own. And of course, if you don't want to hear me, just play some music on it. But please try this one at home, because it is so much fun and you really can make your own unique piece. So this was my DIY for my first try making a gnome. And if you see me, like I always say, you made it to the end. And of course, thank you so much, Donna, for hosting this great challenge. I had so much fun. And of course, I hope you enjoyed seeing my dear wife, my two little Christmas gnomes. And if you do, and you like this kind of content, I hope you will consider subscribing to Diana, my channel, because there will be lots of more beautiful videos for the coming Christmas season. So click the subscribe button and the bell so you will be notified every time we upload our video. So enough talking. I wish you all a beautiful, beautiful day. Take care of yourself, take care of each other, and please be safe. And we hope to see you in another video. Love from Diana and me. Bye everyone.